Hey guys, Dylan from the Geek Door here, and today I'll be bringing you my reaction to Star Wars The Clone Wars Season 3 Episode 15, titled Overlords. Anakin learns of his destiny from a family of Force wielders. Now, that synopsis implies that Anakin has always known, well, not always, but knew for ages before Revenge of the Sith, that he would descend into the dark side, end up killing the majority of the Jedis, and then ultimately return to the light at the end. So, if he knew that, and still got seduced by the power promised by Palpatine, that's a question of character. But let's see how much he does actually learn. In 3, 2, 1, go. Don't know why I didn't play, but... balance is found in the one who faces his guilt. Far beyond. Interesting. Yeah, that would be concerning if that suddenly appeared out of nowhere. So it seems this place is only accessible by people with the Force. It makes you wonder if there was someone who wasn't Force sensitive on this ship, what would happen? Curiouser and curiouser. What, are they all going to get their own path that they think they need to go down? Well, they both seem interesting. Are you the gatekeeper? It's Keymaster, but... was a weird sound. Yeah, of course. Why does he look like the Grand Inquisitor? I mean, to be fair, only Anakin was told to wait, and he did disobey. So I'm assuming the statues on either side of his chair were the sister and the brother. Well, the daughter and the brother. What did she say she was? Now, was he actually there, or was that a vision given by? Can't exactly do that even if I wanted to. Jedi or another. I'm assuming this isn't just a simple test, considering this is like a 3-episode arc, but. I have a feeling, yep, you go into the temple. Good in the bad, and the bad in the good. It's not exactly a Jedi way of doing things. Ah, so that's what it means by destiny. It is one way to bring balance to the Force. Interesting. There was a bit of a Vader sting in that. So that's what the balance of the Force is. Not destroying the Sith or saving the Jedi or anything like that. It is to keep the Force in balance by taming the, like, what, like, embodiments, I guess? She was not entirely good, and he seemed more helpful than a dark side user, so... Really? So, now, the irony would be if the one who looks like they're good, the daughter, is actually the dark side embodiment, and the one who seems Sith-like was actually the helpful one. Like, now that would be a twist. I don't see them going that way, but... Would be interesting because she seemed a lot more intense than the son. That was Sam Witwer as the son. Interesting. So it was Lloyd Scherr as the father. It was Adrian Wilkinson as the daughter and Sam Witwer as the son. Yeah, she seemed a lot more intense than he did. He seemed like, sure, he seemed ambivalent to everything, but he did also reiterate the warning that that place gets bad at night, and to find a shelter. Also, I'm assuming that wasn't actually Qui-Gon, because Obi-Wan isn't told that Qui-Gon can actually manifest as a Force ghost until Revenge of the Sith. Interestingly enough, Qui-Gon isn't even credited as in this episode. And I'm going to assume it was Ashley who did the older Ahsoka. Shmi's not in the credits, like... Interesting. Anyway, Lloyd Scherr was also Fillmore from the Cars series. If I'm not mistaken, that's the Lowrider. No, that's the van. The combi. And as for Adrian, do I know her from anything? Not really. Yeah, not seeing anything. A few video games, but other than that, nothing, and nothing I would have played anyway. Okay. It is interesting that Qui-Gon and Shmi are not actually credited for this. Yeah. Why did? How the hell did I manage that? So, it seems that somehow, in trying to load up the credits for episode 15, it loaded the credits for episode 16. Oh, that was actually Liam Neeson. Okay. Pamela August. Actually, that's actually the one who plays Shmi as well. Rightio then. That is surprising. Yeah. Anyway, I don't know how it managed to skip over to episode 16 to show the credits when I clicked on episode 15, but yeah. Anyway, still had the same characters, so. But anyway, it was an interesting episode. It's gonna be, because they left the planet, so you assume that would be the end of this arc. Or, well, they started flying off, but as I said, this was the first of a 3-episode arc, so who knows? But I'll catch you in the next one.